Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Liftoff. Clearly, the more we learn about the universe and deep space, the more we realize that it is more dangerous than we thought. For years now, ever since astronomers discovered another planet in the early years of the 1990s, they have been working to find out how far and wide the universe goes. And for sure, it is quite large. There are billions of planets and exoplanets out there, most of which have not even been discovered yet. Most of the ones that have been discovered have been with the help of telescopes that float around, which include the Hubble Space Telescope and the Voyager 1 and 2 spacecraft, among others. The initial extrasolar, better known as exoplanets to be discovered, were orbiting the pulsar PSR 1257+12. They were discovered by Alexander Wolzogen and Dale Frail. The initial discovery was followed up by the observation of 51 Pegasi b, which was the first exoplanet to ever be discovered around a sun-like star. This happened in 1995. And ever since then, the list of exoplanets has been expanding over the years. So far, there are over 4,000 worlds that have been discovered, with many more to be discovered. As the technology to observe these planets improves, scientists are discovering some of the most terrifying planets ever. It turns out that there are more dangerous worlds out there, others that you can't even imagine. But what makes them so terrifying? What are some examples of these planets? Let's find out. Before we continue, make sure you smash that like button and the subscribe button as well to get nothing but the latest updates on Elon Musk, SpaceX, Tesla, science, technology, and so much more. And with that, let's find out what some of these dangerous worlds are. There is an exoplanet out there that rains molten iron. You can only imagine how hot it would have to be to melt iron. WASP 76b was discovered in 2013, and it was further investigated by the Espresso instrument on the Very Large Telescope in 2020. It was discovered that this planet is tidally locked to its parent star, BD 01316. This simply means that one side of the planet is permanently facing the star, making it have temperatures of up to 4,532 degrees Fahrenheit. This is definitely hot enough to vaporize iron. The side facing the star receives 1,000 times the radiation Earth receives from the Sun. On the other hand, the side facing away from the F-type star has a perpetual night. Even though the day side of the planet has some of the worst temperatures ever, the dark side isn't as pleasant as you would think. The side of WASP 76b that is facing away from the star is as cold as 1,832 degrees Fahrenheit. This means that when the iron vapor is carried to the other side of the planet by the powerful winds, it is cooled, later forming liquid droplets. These are the droplets that fall to the ground, destroying the surface of the cooler side. Astronomers were puzzled by the lack of any traces of it on one side of the world. So upon further investigation, they discovered that it was raining molten iron. But if you thought molten iron rain was bad enough, wait till you head over to HD 189733b. Where it rains molten glass. If you look at an image of the planet HD 189733b, you will see it as a beautiful and tranquil world that looks like a marble. However, looks can be deceiving, which is the case with this giant gas planet. It only takes 2.2 days to complete an orbit around the Sun. This beautiful blue color comes from the deadly weather, which is mostly comprised of rains of molten glass. In addition, the exoplanet discovered in 2005 by NASA's Chandra X-ray Observatory and ESA's XMM Newton X-ray telescopes, it has winds that travel up to 5,600 miles per hour. These supersonic winds cause the exoplanet's glass rain to move sideways towards the ground rather than just falling. This makes them tiny little projectiles that can easily cut through if they fall on any flesh. However, the dangerous weather is not the only interesting thing about this planet. Scientists have discovered that the planet has a much larger atmosphere than any other planet. Because of this extended atmosphere, the planet catches some more radiation thanks to its perilously close orbit. This raises the temperature on the surface of this planet to about 1700 degrees Fahrenheit. Given that the planet's atmosphere is capturing so much radiation, that means that the planet is being stripped off into space faster. As HD 189733b was growing a thicker atmosphere, Gliese 1132b was growing a second atmosphere. This exoplanet is similar to Earth in so many ways. The radius and the mass are slightly bigger, but the age is just like Mother Earth. The only major difference is that this world orbits much closer to its red dwarf parent star, making it complete an orbit in just 1.6 days. This makes Gliese 1132b have a much higher surface temperature than our planet. If you combine that with the intense radiation that it receives, the planet's atmosphere is being stripped off into space. However, as astronomers were observing this planet, they discovered something strange was going on here. The gravitational pull, which is 20% greater than the Sun, causes there to be a tidal force that ends up squeezing and stretching the planet. Because of this flexing, there is violent volcanic activity that causes the gases to rush to the world's surface. According to NASA, these gases accumulate, building some sort of second atmosphere on the planet. This is pretty interesting for astronomers given that they have never seen anything like it before. But it also gives them a chance to study the chemical makeup of an exoplanet's interior. There is a world out there that is referred to as a world of fire and ice. Upsilon Andromeda b is an exoplanet that is tidally locked to its host star, taking only 5 days to complete an orbit. What makes this planet, previously referred to as Sapphire, dangerous is the great difference that is present between the day side and the night side. The day side can have temperatures of up to 2,912 degrees Fahrenheit, while the night side can go as low as minus 4 degrees Fahrenheit. This means that moving from the night side to the day side would be like moving from Antarctica and jumping straight into a volcano. Even though there are more tidally locked planets, none have the difference in the two sides that Upsilon Andromeda b does. The main reason behind this could be because of the size of its parent star, Upsilon Andromeda a. Either that, or the fact that the star has a hotspot that is almost directly overhead of this exoplanet. As if that wasn't hot enough, we have a planet that can be considered literal hell. 55 Cancri e is yet another planet on the list of exoplanets that are close to their host stars. This planet only takes 18 hours to complete an orbit, so you can imagine how close it is to its star. It also happens to be too hot, going from temperatures of up to 4,172 degrees Fahrenheit. But what makes this planet one of a kind is its composition. Formerly known as Janssen, the planet is twice the size of Earth, with about 9 times the mass. It's believed that this exoplanet is composed of high-pressed carbon that is in the form of graphite and diamonds, mixed with some iron and other elements. This was according to the astronomers who observed the planet. The idea that this planet is made of nothing but diamonds has been challenged ever since the planet was discovered in 2004. Another interesting thing about this planet is that it is so hot that the surface is also believed to be made of nothing but molten lava. And if what the scientists are saying about the planet is true, that it is made of diamond, then that is some serious heat that keeps it in a molten state. This has made it a hellish planet with nothing but high temperatures there. Even with all the extreme worlds that have been discovered out there, there are still so many more that are left undiscovered. They may exist in systems just like ours or even in systems that we've encountered before. With the help of the James Webb Space Telescope, scientists can now look into the atmospheres of these planets and find out what they are really composed of. Which exoplanet was the most interesting to you? Feel free to let us know in the comment section below. Also, before you go, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for nothing but the latest updates on Elon Musk, SpaceX, Tesla, science, space, technology, and so much more. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.